Well, pleased to welcome to Halton News once again today, Maddie Janoda. She is a registered veterinary technician at Oakville and Milton Humane Society. Maddie, spring is in the air.
It sure is, and sure sign of that is we just got our first litter of abandoned baby squirrels that came in last night this morning, so I figured it'd be a good time to chat about that as we get into kind of the first squirrel litter season of the year. They'll have a second one in the summer, but as the weather gets warmer, people start to find these baby squirrels, and figured it's a good opportunity to chat about what to do if you do find some baby squirrels.
I was actually surprised that this happens. So people find baby squirrels, and I guess they just kind of pick them up in a towel maybe and bring them into you guys? And is that the right thing to do? Or what should you do if you come across a nest of baby squirrels?
Yeah, absolutely. So there are some that make their way to us. We do try to, have a call with anyone who calls in saying that they found some baby squirrels to kind of assess whether they do need to go to a wildlife rehabber or not. Our first thought is always to try to reunite the babies with their mom. Mom squirrel is going to do a way better job than any human could hope to do about raising them. So it's always the first choice option for them. A couple things to check is make sure that they appear to be a baby healthy baby rather. So things to look for, they don't want to be covered in any fly larvae. You should see them moving around, that sort of thing. And no obvious injury. So if you see any injuries, blood on them, that sort of thing, then absolutely we'll want to take a look at them for that. But if they appear by all means healthy, some things that we want to do is want to track that mom squirrel back to them. So she'll actually pick them up, take them back to the nest and raise them on her own. So the first thing to do, get a little cardboard box, shoe boxes, perfect. Line it with a nice soft cloth, t-shirt, that sort of thing. And we want to have a passive heat source. We don't want any heat on them directly because we risk burns, overheating, that sort of thing. But we really don't want them getting too cold, because if they get too cold, mom won't come back and take them back to the nest. So things that work really well, if the area that they're found in happens to be close to your house, you can run a heating pad out, have it under half the box set on low. Otherwise, just plastic water bottle filled with hot tap water, or filling a sock, old sock you might have laying around, with some dry rice and microwaving it until it's good and warm to the touch, but not scalding hot. And you're just going to put that in the box between a layer of cloth with them and the babies. As I say, you don't want it touching them directly, but if have your cloth lining, have your babies in, maybe fold the cloth around so that they're kind of contained to one side so that they stay nice and close to each other, keep that body heat going, and then tuck your warming device, be it the water bottle or the rice sock, underneath the cloth so that it's just radiating heat onto them. And then you're going to want to have that box as close as possible to where you found the babies. It'll typically be at the bottom of a tree, so you want to keep them nice and close by to where mom might have last seen them. And you can actually play from your phone, or if you have a wireless Bluetooth speaker, that's even better. From right beside the box, you can play distressed baby squirrel sounds. Quick search, Google, YouTube will come up with a little video for it. And this, the sound of it actually attracts the mom to come back if she's nearby. So you don't want to play that for too long, because otherwise it will attract predators. But by playing the sounds for, a minute or two, if mom's in the area, she'll hear and should hopefully make her way down. The reason I say a Bluetooth speaker is even better, because if you can be away from the box while that's happening, she's not going to come back if you're standing right over top watching them. She's not going to come back and pick them up and take them back to the nest. And even if you see any tree, a tree, one nest is destroyed, they often have multiple nesting locations, so she can always take them back to another spot. But you want to resist the urge to check on them, every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes. You just want to leave them, let mom come back, leave them be undisturbed, watching them from out the window to make sure, nothing else is coming to get them, that sort of thing. Squirrels only active in the daytime, so we're not going to be leaving them out overnight, just in daylight hours. And you do want to check on them periodically. So if they're, quite small, don't seem to have any hair on them, checking on them every couple of hours, where the older they get, you can get up to every 4 to 6 hours that you're checking on them. If by the end of the day or by the end of the afternoon, if you found them midday, no sign of mom, despite everything that's been going on, at that point, we'd say, okay, this reuniting hasn't been successful, and we'd take them and try to find them a spot at rehab at that point.
So if that does happen, and if they do make their way to you guys at Oakville Milton Humane Society, then what happens over there? I mean, you take care of them, you raise them. Is the goal to put them back out into the wilderness? And how long does that process take?
Yeah, so definitely. So we don't do any of the care for them ourselves. We're not a licensed wildlife rehab facility, so we can only keep them for 24 hours. So we basically just keep them warm. If they're dehydrated, we'll give them some sub-Q fluids. That is the other thing I did want to mention. Under no circumstances should you feed them or give them anything to drink. Can actually be really detrimental to their health if they're given anything they shouldn't have. So we just kind of keep them hydrated, keep them warm, and then arrange a spot at one of the various wildlife rehab facilities that we work with. And they'll raise them up until they're old enough to be independent and be released.
There you go. All you need to know, including the Bluetooth speaker and or iPhone, a little bit of Google and YouTube to help these squirrels find their mums once again. Maddie, thank you for the tips. I had no idea what to do. So this is fantastic. Thank you so much.
Oh, anytime. No problem.